Hello, I'm Kurt Browning, Pasco County Superintendent of Schools. In recent weeks and months, our schools have experienced a troubling number of threatening comments and anonymous threats posted on social media. Parents, many of you know exactly what I'm talking about. You've experienced the frustration of knowing that your child's school is on a controlled campus, or you have seen the images of law enforcement surrounding your child's school. It's scary, it's stressful, and at times, it's confusing. In this brief video, I want to put this phenomenon into perspective and make a plea to parents and students. First of all, this is not new, and it is not unique to Pasco schools. However, it has gotten out of hand. Social media has made it worse, and we need to put an end to it. I have to say that in Pasco, we are extremely fortunate. We have law enforcement partners, the Pasco Sheriff's Office and the municipal departments, who are as committed as we are to taking all threats seriously and to investigating thoroughly. Often that results in disruption and loss of instructional time, not to mention the time and expense that law enforcement devotes to their often complex investigations. I'm happy to report that those investigations recently resulted in two arrests. Thanks to law enforcement and their sophisticated investigations, teens who thought they were anonymous and untraceable on social media soon found out otherwise. Their misbehaviors, their crimes, resulted in significant disruption at school. Now they face serious criminal charges. As I've said before, making anonymous social media threats is not a joke. It is a crime. That is the only appropriate way to deal with these threats, and that's how we will continue to deal with them. Now, I have a message for parents and a message for students. Parents, when we notify you that a threat against your student's school was a hoax or that it was unfounded, we receive two kinds of responses. There are those parents who thank us for making safety a priority, and there are those who question why it was necessary to disrupt the school day or ask why we can't keep the school safe. To that latter group, I say, we do everything we can to keep students and staff safe, and we minimize disruption as much as possible. We cannot and we will not rush an investigation. There are no shortcuts. We resume our normal school day as soon as we know it is safe to do so, and we notify parents about what's going on as soon as we sort out the facts. I ask for your patience, and I ask that you join us in sending a clear message to your students. What is our message to students? First, if you are thinking it would be clever or funny to send out a threatening message or make a threatening comment, even if it's just to one friend, don't do it. Your comment or your message will make the rounds, and it will not be treated as a joke. We will make every effort to determine where it originated, and you will face serious consequences. Most students are as frustrated as we are and have had to weather the disruptions to their campus. To those students, I say that if you become aware of a social media post or comments that concern you, report it to law enforcement or to school administration. It will be investigated. Don't spread the rumor or share it on social media. That just makes it worse. To summarize, I want parents and students to know that safety truly is our highest priority. The only way to keep our campuses safe is to take all threats seriously and to take nothing for granted. With patience and with students, parents, and law enforcement all working together, we can reduce or eliminate these threats and devote the entire school day to delivering the world-class education our students deserve. Thank you.